Here we're going to look at just some basic plotting. Like if you've never plotted in MATLAB before, it's super fun. It's just about as straightforward as you can hope for. I actually ended up doing these notes back in a regular .m file, so just new script instead of a live script, because plotting in live scripts, I don't know, it's just still not doing what I want it to do, because I think live scripts are still kind of, I don't know, it's just inconsistent. So rather than being like, well, sometimes it does this, but sometimes it randomly does this, to just be like, okay, do it here and it'll be fine. So this is how it was always kind of meant to be. So if you just kind of have an X and a Y, you don't even really need to say figure one. That was back when I was trying to do this with a live script. You can just be plot X, Y, run it, and yes, thank you. I don't want to look at that right now. And you've got yourself a little, you know, what do you call it? Quadratic thingy. You're like, yay, it's a quadratic. Beautiful plot does exactly what you want it to do. Okay, so now clearly though, if you're making these plots for anyone besides yourself, you're going to want to label your data. So title, axis label, usually with units, a y-axis label, usually with units. And the way that you would do that is, you know, you could just plot it again. Figure one doesn't have to be there, but it can be, it doesn't really matter. So you got your X, you got your Y, and you could do title, time, distance. The biggest problem that most students will do here is they'll misspell the word label. Like, so if you do that, you'll see there's an error down here that says undefined function X label, because X label is not a word, it's X label. But if you do X label, if you can't find your chart or your figure, it's probably because it's in your toolbar. And especially if you have your things in your toolbar stacked, sometimes the things are stacked on top of each other. But anyway, there you go. There's your X label and your Y label and your title. And it's just, isn't this just the best thing that you've ever done? And it's clearly super, super complicated. No, okay. So there you go. There's your basic with plotting. Now it's weird because if you want to do something with more than one graph, so look at what happens here. So if I've got my X and I'm gonna do X squared, I'll leave a plus five on there. But if I have X squared and then X cubed, if I try to plot XY and then XZ, I'm like, here's both my graphs. So I'm gonna run this and I'll show you what you get. Is you get just this. So I just get the first graph. So I'm like, okay, clearly something weird happened. So I'm gonna run it again. No, I just still got the one graph. Okay, so I'm gonna show you something. I'm gonna hit pause for 2 seconds. And then I'm gonna plot the second one. So I'm gonna run this again, run section, there, and there. Okay, so see, it was plotting the first thing, but then it immediately plotted the second thing. I'm gonna run that again so you can kind of see what's going on. So I'm gonna hit run section, we're gonna get our regular thingy, and then we're gonna get our second thingy. So it's plotting both of them, but without the pause function in there, it's doing it instantaneously, so it's like boom, boom. But you can't see the other one because it's a computer and it goes faster than you. Okay, so basically what we do is we can say something called hold on. So basically once we start the first plot, we'll be like, hold on, dude, and then we'll plot it. And once we're kind of happy and we're done, we can say hold off so that it doesn't affect us in future plots. So hold on, you just have to say hold on once. You could, you know, plot X sine X plus six. And keep plotting more and more stuff, but now I can keep plotting more and more things. So here, let me take this one out because that was just for funsies, but here you go. So there's my quadratic and there's my thingy with 3 power. Talking is hard today, which is why I decided to record videos, because that's a perfect time. So essentially, but what you see is I plotted the first one, then it said hold on, and plotted the second one, and it did it in a different color, which is pretty great, so we're like, thanks. But again, you don't have to put, if you wanted to plot a third thing, and you don't have to pre-load them, you can just load them in as you go. You know, I could come in here, and, wait, what did I do? Control enter, maybe? Oh, it's already down here. There's the next one, so this is probably the sine function that's in here. You just can't see it because there's all this crazy stuff going on, because sine function isn't really very interesting. Okay, so excited. No, but that's okay. This is not meant to be terribly exciting. This is, after all, just basic plotting, not super exciting plotting. Okay, that was fun. Now, it would be nice. Now, I know because I have basic math skills that this is the sine and this is the quadratic and this is the thingy that I don't know the name of. So, obviously, I'm not actually that skilled. So, let me pull all this down here again. So, if you want to know which graph is which, we can use something called legend, okay? So, if I come here after the title, I can be like, legend. And if I list them in order, I can be like, it'll label it. So I can be like, you know, first one, second one, and third one. Okay? So if I just run this, first one, second one, third one. Now, obviously, that's silly. I'm going to actually dock this just so I don't have to keep popping it back up. I'm going to dock it over here. First one, second one, third one. But yeah, obviously, you can call it, instead of calling it first, second, and third, I could call it x squared, and I already forgot what the next one was, x cubed, so y equals x cubed, y equals x squared, and y equals sine of x plus 6, maybe, and then I run it, and look how pretty, it even does pretty print, look, I love it now, it didn't used to do that. This is really awesome. So it's y equals x up squared, y equals up cubed, and then y equals sine of x plus 6. Isn't that pretty? And then again, you can x label, except spell it correctly. Your face is pretty. And then you can y label. I like chicken. And there you go. So isn't that wonderful? Don't you just love it? Okay. Now, also, I'm just going to keep all this code because it's pretty. Because we kind of talked about how this here is kind of interesting. So, like, let's say we wanted to zoom on it. Now we can just click the zoomy button and be like, okay. But, like, maybe we want to do that automatically and not have to click the zoomy button every time. So what we could do is we could actually use the axis function. And again, that can kind of go toward the end. I recommend putting like all your like special thingies at the end after kind of everything else is up. So it's axis with an I, not axes. If you ever get confused, you can always go to help. Axis is the one that we're using. It'll say like axis controls axis scaling and appearance. So it's x min, x max, y min, y max. So, but if you go help axes, then it's like creates axes graphics objects, and you're like, I don't know what that means, so it's probably not what I want to use. So I'll go help axis. So again, x min, x max, y min, y max. So that's what I'm going for. So I can be like, okay, axis, and I always get it wrong. I always talk myself into the one with the E. So that's why I'm telling you how to figure it out. So this is a little annoying because it's a thing that's in parentheses and brackets because it's a matrix. So it's a function. So this is the function part, right? Like the function. But the argument of the function is a matrix. And the matrix size is a 1 by 4. Okay, so the x, let's say we want the x to go from -1.5 to 1.5. And we want the y to go from -10 to 10. Okay, so something like that. So -1.5 to 5, -10 to 10. And you don't really need commas in there. I'm just being weird. So I'm gonna go ahead and go and see there. I've got my really pretty perfect axes, the ones that I wanted. Okay, now looking at this, this is actually really not that nice of a picture. And that's because when I zoom in, remember that this x value, if I unsuppress this and run it, it's only doing every like honk, 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 right? I don't know why I'm honking, hungry. But it's only doing every single element, like every step. So, I mean, you can fix it and be like, I want you to do half steps. And that does make it a little bit better. You could go like super tiny half steps and that does make it pretty. But honestly, generally what I would say is if I was going to do something like this, I wouldn't even do this at all. I would do something like lin space and go from -5 to 5 and just put in like a whole bunch of stinking points, because nobody charges me for the number of points I use, so I'm going to use all of them and stick it to the man, because I don't know, somehow that made sense when I said it. So I'm going to put in like a whole bunch of points and it's beautiful. So see, if I put in like 10 points, it's kind of skunky. And if I put in 100 points, it's already smooth. So I really don't need to put in this many points. It's just going to make it take longer potentially. But I kind of like using lin space a little bit better, because then just whenever the graph isn't smooth, I don't have to think about, well, what do I need to divide it by? I can just be like, oh, I'm going to add a zero. And then I run it. And it's nice. So this is kind of a cool thing, just to kind of get you started with making some pretty plots in MATLAB.